Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss about the topic programmable logic devices. Okay, so these programmable logic devices also will come under sequential circuits. Okay, so in programmable devices, in main, we are going to discuss about PROM and about PAL and PLA. These three are the important topics that we got to discuss in under the programmable logic devices. Okay, students, these programmable logic devices are very much helpful for us if we want to change a small program in the circuit and to get a different output. For example, if you have ICs, okay, integrated chips, they can work, they can function for a particular function itself. If you're having a full adder or a half adder in a IC form, they can just simply do addition process of adding of 2 bits or 3 bits. That's it. They can work only for adding of the 2 bits or 3 bits, like that if you're having IC. But if you have designed a programmable logic device using a small programming inside the chip, okay, using a small programming inside the chip, we can get different outputs with the help of same design part. Okay, that is what is a small difference you can find between ICs and programmable logic devices. In ICs, if you design for a particular operation, just that particular operation can be done with the help of IC. Whereas if you go for programmable logic device, in all programmable logic device, you can have a small programs which can be done. A very small programming we can do just to operate out, just to have different applications with the help of same design. Okay, so that is only the difference you can find between programmable logic devices and ICs. Okay, then let us go, students, directly we'll go into the PROM and we'll see how this PROM can be designed for the different combinational circuit design parts. Okay, so students, you can see the basic block diagram of a PROM. Okay, PROM, programmable read-only memory. Okay, so a PROM will have n inputs and m outputs. Okay, if you are designing a 2 power n into m PROM actually. Okay, in a PROM you will have a decoder and also you will have a programmable OR array actually. Okay, these are the two important parts we can see in programmable read-only memory. What are they? We'll have a decoder and you will have programmable OR array. Programmable OR array. These are the things you can see in a PROM part. Okay, so you can see, students, here they are giving n inputs. Those n inputs we can call as address, okay, and we'll have the outputs what you're getting out of it will be called as word, okay, word in a PROM circuit here, okay. Let us see, students, we'll have very simple design for PROM here. You can see here how they are going to design a 64x4 PROM here, 64x4 PROM. Here, if you want to design 64x4 PROM, you should have a decoder and programmable OR array is very, very important in PROM circuit design. See here, students, I need a 6:64 decoder for designing 64x4 PROM. 64x4 PROM. Here, 64 lines, what you're going to have at the output of decoder is given here, 64, okay? And how many outputs you are going to have? These four outputs are given here, okay? 64x4 means the number of output lines you can see at your output of the decoder is 64, and four outputs what you can see at the end of R array are your four. Okay, the outputs how many you're going to consider in a design of a PROM are mentioned in here. Okay, students, you have to go in a reverse process in order to find the construction of a PROM. If you're trying to design a 64x4 PROM, four outputs you got to have for PROM and 64 lines you got to have as inputs for OR arrays. Okay, this is called OR array. Okay, the array or group of OR gates which can be programmable are called OR array. And if you're having 64, okay, if you're having 64 address lines or output lines, 64 output lines, you can simply say how many inputs you can have for a decoder. Okay, n is to 2 power n is a formula you can use to find number of inputs and output for a decoder. Okay, so listen, students, once again, I'm saying if you're trying to construct a 64x4 PROM, you should have four outputs. You can see here F1, F2, F3 and F4 are four outputs you have. And 64 lines of inputs you should get for OR array. Each OR gate, okay, each OR gate is, okay, each OR gate is given with a 64 input lines from your decoder. And also, you know, if you're having 64 output lines from the decoder, you should definitely have 6 input lines on a decoder. That is what is very important here, students. Okay, you should definitely have 6 input for a decoder. So how you are designing, let's look at here. If you are designing 64 into 4, take 6 input lines in a decoder, then you will definitely get 64 output lines. Okay, from each line of your 64 lines, you should have a connection for each OR gate. Okay, that is mandatory, students. From each and every output line in 64 lines from 0 to 63, 64 output lines will be there for a decoder. From each and every line, you should have a connection for each OR gate. Okay. From which line you're going to get your output, that will be connected. Remaining all will be open. That is how you're going to have here, students. Since I have 64 input lines for these OR gates, and since I have 4 OR gates, 64 into 4, 256 fuses you can see here in the OR array, 256 fuses. Which one you need as a connection, that fuse will be in closed condition. Which connection is not needed, then you can open it. That is called programming. That is called programming here, students. Okay, it is not nothing very big programming you have to do in PLDs. Programming in PLDs is very, very, very simple. Nothing but connecting the fuses or not connecting or disconnecting the fuses is called programming here. In the connection of 64 into 4 PROM, if you want to have a connection, just you will connect it. If you want to open it, if you don't want to have a connection for this F1, we will try to open it. Okay, that is a basic way of designing any PROM circuit. You can see very, 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 very big circuit. This is actually, you have 64 output lines, means you should have a connection for 64 lines to this OR gate, another 64 connections for this OR gate, another 64 connections for this OR gate. Like that, you have to have the connections. Now, let us see how we can design a PROM circuit in small. Okay, then you can understand very easily how we can design a combinational circuit with the help of PROM in here. Look at here, students, I'm showing you an example. Implement the following Boolean function, okay, using PROM for the functions F1 of A1 comma A0 is equal to summation small m of 1 comma 2. And F2 of A1 comma A0 is equal to summation small m of 0 comma 1 comma 3. Here, they have given two functions, students, two outputs, F1 and F2. And they have given the connections from where you got to take the connections also. And they're asking us to design this with the help of PROM. Students, when you're trying to design using a PROM, you should first of all remember that a decoder and OR array is very, very important in PROM design part. So since just look at the contents, what they have given in the question, they have given F1 and F2, means they ask you to design two functions, F1 and F2. So here there are two outputs, F1 and F2 here. Inside the function F1 and F2, they gave how many inputs you are going to consider here. You need to consider here, that is A1 and A0 and A1 and A0. So there are two functions, outputs, F1 and F is to be designed with the help of the inputs A1 and A0. So there are two inputs and two outputs you have in this PROM. Okay, PROM. Now look at here, students. You are starting from 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, starting from 0 to 3, you have totally 4 output lines here, 4 min terms here. 0 to 4, 0 to 3, totally 4 min terms you have here. Okay. Now, students, how many inputs you can see here? Tell me how many inputs you can see in the given question?
Two inputs.
So let us start designing of PROM by designing a decoder. Since you have two inputs, I am taking those two here, A0, A1. If you have two inputs for a decoder, how many outputs you will have? 2 power 2.
Four outputs.
I have taken 1, 2, 3, and 4, starting from 0 to 3. 0th line, first line, second line, third line, or 0th output, first output, second output, and third output. There are 4 output lines you have here. So decoder part is completed, students. You need to analyze the question like that. How many inputs they have given? 2 inputs, A0 and A1. So take A0 and A1 for a decoder. If you have 2 inputs for a decoder, totally you will have 4 output lines, 0, 1, 2, and 3. Look at here, students. After completion of decoder, you need to move to programmable OR array. Programmable OR array. Students understand programmable OR array means you can have connections from all the lines, but you can give fuses for which you need only connection. That is called programmable OR array. You can have connections from all the things, but for which lines you need connection, for them only you're going to have the fuse. For rest of the things, you are not going to give any fuse like that. Let us see how you're going to give the OR function, OR array here. Students, when I'm trying to design the first output F1, I should have the connections only from the two lines. What are they?
First, one and second.
So in programmable OR array, I told you already, you need to have connection from all the lines, all the output lines. So I have taken connection from all the lines, but you need only the connections from one and two. So zero, first, second, and third. So I'm only taking the connection from one and two here. Fuses are connected only for the lines one and two here, but zero and three. Okay, zero and three are not connected here. Now let us go for the design of second function. For F2, I need to get connections from 0, 1, and 3 here. But initially, I'm taking connections from all the input lines, all the output lines of the decoder, 0, 1, 2, and 3. But for the design of second F2, function F2, I need to get only the connections from 0, 1, and 3. So 0th line is connected via fuse, first line is connected via fuse, and 2 is left alone since we don't need any connection for F2, and 3 is connected via fuse. That is how I'm going to get a design of your PROM, students. Okay, students, do you have any doubts in design of this PROM? Students, tell me, what is this PROM, configuration of this PROM? You can see here, this is 64 into 4 PROM. Like this, can you tell me what is the configuration of this PROM? Can you tell me what is the configuration of this PROM, students? Here you can see, if I have 64 output lines from the decoder, I'm writing 64 into, since I have four output lines, I'm writing this as 64 into 4 PROM. Like that, can you tell me what is this PROM actually?
4 into 2, sir.
Yeah.
4 into 2, sir.
This,
four
is, into two, sir.
Yeah, this is actually 4 into 2 PROM. There are four elements in this given function, and there are two output lines, so it is 4 into 2 PROM, clearly, students. Okay, now like this you can design any PROM. They may give you F1 of A1 comma, sorry, A2 comma A1 comma A0 is equal to summation small m of some functions, F2 of A1, A2 comma A1 comma A0 equal to some functions. They can give you and they ask you to design. Then if they are giving A2, A1 and A0, how many inputs you should consider for a decoder? How many inputs you should consider, students? If I'm having A2, A1 and A0, three inputs you should consider.
Three inputs.
How many outputs you will get at that time?
Eight outputs.
From eight outputs, we can design our function, what they have asked. Okay, you can have F1, F2 and F3 like that. They can give you number of outputs. Okay, so if I'm having a number of outputs, you can find what is a PROM configuration you're going to design. So this is about PROM, students. That is our first programmable logic device, design of PROM. They can ask you in different way also to design a PROM, like design a PROM with an inputs, with a binary input of A1, A2, A1 and A0, means three inputs, which will give you a XS3 output, In that case, you need to consider a different way of designing PROM. Okay, so I will show that as an assignment. Okay, I will give that as an assignment. I will send the material regarding that. Just follow through that. But they will ask you for different conditions to design a PROM, different applications here. Okay, like that, you need to design a PROM. In PROM, the main contents are blocks are your decoder and programmable OR array. In PROM, you will have a decoder and a programmable OR array, students. That is about PROM. Now let us go and see a programmable logic array. Programmable logic array. That is our second PLD, programmable logic device. Programmable logic array. In most of the cases, they will call this as a PLA. Okay, programmable logic array can also be called as PLA. I have shown you a block diagram which will give you an information, entire information regarding what are the blocks you can find in a programmable logic array. Okay, you can see students, initially I'm having a input buffer, then an AND matrix or AND array, they can call AND matrix or AND array, means group of AND gates you can find in there. So they're calling it as AND matrix, or we can call that also as AND array, and that will be followed by OR matrix or OR array, and that will be followed by inverter or non-inverter matrix, and followed by outputs. Okay, outputs of a programmable logic array. These are the blocks you can find in a PLA design part. Okay, what are they? Input buffer, AND matrix, OR matrix, then inverter or non-inverter matrix, and output. Okay, PLA. So these are the things you can see in a programmable logic array, students. Okay, so then let us come and see how you are going to design a programmable logic array. For this, we should definitely understand two more very, very important points, friends. There are two more important points what we should remember here on. Which matrix is programmable, which is not programmable. That is very, very important here, students. You have two arrays here. What are they? One is AND matrix or AND array. That is one part. And that is followed by OR array. Okay, there you have group of AND gates and a group of OR gates. These are the things you can see in design of PLA. In that, which is programmable, which is not programmable. In PLA, both AND gate and AND array and OR array, both are programmable. That is the biggest advantage you will have in PLA. We can program AND array and we can program OR array. Like that, a PLA structure will be looking like. Okay. But when you go for the second one, students, recently we have seen PROM. In that, after decoder, we have programmable OR array. There is no AND array in there. Like that, if you go for PLA, you will have AND array and OR array. Both will be available. But if you go for a programmability, both AND array and OR array, both will be programmable. We can design with the help of both AND matrix and OR matrix. That is the advantage you have here. Okay. And then if you go for the next, see here, I'm explaining you how you're going to design a combinational logic or combinational circuit with the help of this PLA. Students, in the question, when they're asking a design about PLA, they will give all these contents. That is, the functions or outputs for which you need to design your PLA, programmable logic array, and the functions they have given as F1 is equal to summation small m of 3, 5, 7, and F2 is equal to summation small m of 4, 5, 7. These are the functions they are asking us to design with the help of PLA. And the most important thing is about this part. This is most important part when you are trying to design with the help of PLA. That is, how many inputs you should consider, how many product terms you should consider, and how many outputs you should have in a PLA. All these things should be known for us before you go for a design part. This is very, very, very important, students. Okay. So when you're trying to design a program, combinational logic with the help of PLA, it is very much essential for us to know how many inputs you should use, how many product terms you should have, and how many outputs you are going to design. These three things are to be known very well, or very much. These are very, very, very essential, students. Then look at here. There are two functions or two outputs available. What are they, students? They are asking us to design F1 and F2. There are two outputs. So according to the given condition also, we should use only two outputs. So it is matching for us. Okay. Then they are giving us to use only three inputs. We should use only three inputs here. Okay. You need to check the possibility whether we can design the given logic with the help of three inputs or not. That is what you have to check here. Okay. And the number of product terms also you should have when you're doing the process should be three only. Let us go and design a PLA, students, with the information what they have given, and check if we can design this F1 and F2 with the conditions what they have given. Tell me, students, what are the conditions they have given about the input, output, and product terms? How many inputs they're asking us to use?
Three inputs.
How many product terms they are asking us to use?
Three products.
How many outputs?
two outputs.
Yeah, two outputs is very fine. F1 and F2 are the outputs. Then let us go and check the design part. Students, when you are trying to design a PLA, first you need to form a truth table. Okay, first you need to form a truth table. How you need to form the truth table? Students, they told you to design only with the help of three inputs. Let us assume that A, B, and C are the three inputs we are going to consider. Okay, A, B, C are the three inputs you are going to consider. Tell me, students, with the help of three inputs, how many combinations that I can form? How many combinations that I can form?
Eight.
Yeah. Look at here, students, just note it down. What is the function inside F1 and F2? F1 is equal, just note it down, students. I will be asking you. F1 is equal to summation small m of 357. F2 is equal to summation small m of 457. Now, let us go for first step, how to design your truth table. Okay. Now, let me show you how you are going to design the truth table. In the truth table, we should have all these informations. What are they? First input, second input, third input. Okay. These are the three inputs you should have. Then let us go and see what are the outputs you are having. F1 and F2 are the outputs you are going to have here. Okay. Then let us go for design part, students. Let me write the combinations initially. 0, okay. 0, 0. Okay. Then what is my next combination? 0, 0, 1. Then next combination is, what is my next combination, students? Tell me.
0, 1, 0.
Yeah, 0, 1, 0. Okay, then what is my next combination?
0, 1, 1, 1, and 1.
Okay, 0, 1, 1. Then 1, 0.
Double zero. Zero.
Okay,
zero. One double.
Yeah, these are the
1, 0,
combination. Then 1, 0.
1, 0, 1.
Yeah, then the last. Okay, 1, 1, 0. The last combination is 1, 1, and 1.
Okay.
These are the combinations I can find with the help of three inputs. Okay, so I'm writing this one only that they have, since they have given that to use only three inputs in the PLA design part. Now, look at here, students. Tell me, what are the min terms they have given in F1 under F1? What are the min terms?
357, sir.
Yeah. 357,
sir. 357, sir.
F1. 3, 5, okay, 5 and 7. Okay, then for F2, they asked us to use
4, 5, 7.
Okay, 4 and 5 and 7. These are the min terms they are asking us to use here, students. Okay, then let me tell you how to design this truth table. Now, listen. Since in F1 you have only 3, 5, 7. Okay, 3, 5, 7. Just keep 1 at the place of 3, 5, 7 in here. Tell me, students, which is your 3? Since this is 0, 0 is
zero,
not available.
One, zero.
Yeah, 0 is not available in F1. I'm writing 0. 1 is also not available in F1, so I'm writing 0. 2 is also not available in F1, so I'm writing 0. This is 3, students, 0, 1, 1. So 3 is available in F1, so you need to place 1 in here. Okay, then this is 4, which is not available, so I'm placing 0. Okay, then this is 6, which is okay. This is 5. 5 is available, so we need to place 1. 6 is not available in F1, so I'm writing 0. 7 is available in F1, so I'm writing 1. Okay, students, do you understand how to write F1 for the given functions?
Yes, sir.
Then let us see how to design F2. 0, 1, 2, and 3 are not available in F2. 4 is available, so I'm writing 1. Okay, and 5 is also available in F2, writing 1. And 6 is not available, 7 is available, students. So this is your truth table of given PLA. Students, do you have any doubt in designing a truth table for given PLA? This is called truth table for designing PLA. Okay, then let us go and see what is your next part in your design of PLA here. Okay, so after designing your truth table, we need to go for K-map simplification here, students. K-map simplification is very, very important, okay? For the values, what you got one, you need to have a K-map and you need to find what are the product terms you are having. Let us go again. We'll try to simplify K-maps also for the given functions. Now, let us simplify the function for F1. Students, tell me which variable K-map that I'm going to use now.
Three variables.
What are the inputs you have?
A, B, C.
Yeah, A, B, C. So let me take A on this side, okay, and B and C on this side. Now, tell me, students, what are the positions you got one? What are the positions you got one in the truth table? In the first position. Zero.
Five, seven, sir.
Then zero.
Empty,
then
sir.
Zero. Then one. Then zero. One. Zero. One. Isn't it? Is it correct, students? Is it right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, now I'm pairing these two and I'm pairing these two things. Okay. Now tell me, students, what will be your function F1 now? What will be the function F1? F1 is equal to, what is the function you get here? Tell me, what is a function you can get? Tell me about this column. What is this column, students?
BC.
Yeah.
BC, sir.
So I'm writing BC plus, what is a row value, students? What is row group? What is this one? A bar. You'll have B, C here. What you get?
Bar, C, sir.
A bar?
C, sir.
A bar, C. So I got B, C plus A bar, C in here. That is your F1 function. And in same way, let us design the second function F2 here. Okay. So that is also having a three variable K-map in here. So tell me, students, in which areas that I got to place one? So I'm having
sir,
zero.
Sir, BC plus AC, sir. A bar call, sir.
This one is BC clearly. This is A bar only, na?
This no, is, sir. AC, sir.
This one, students. This is, oh, okay, okay, okay. Yes, exactly. AC, not A bar C. This is exactly right. So BC plus AC. Correct. So I'm writing BC plus AC. Okay. Then you know F1. Let us go and look at second function. That is 0, 0, 0, 0. After that, 1, 1, 0, 1 in here. Look at here, students. Same kind of grouping is to be done. These two as one pair and these two as one pair I have to do. Then tell me what will be the function for F2 now? What will be the function F2 now? So let us tell me about first group here. First group here, that is,
yeah,
here we'll have yeah, B bar, C bar. Okay, here we'll have B bar, C bar. And here you can see B bar, C here. So this will be A,
yeah, B bar.
B bar. So first will be A, B bar. Plus, you got to check your second group, students, second pair. Again, that is A, C.
A, C, sir.
So,
A, C, sir.
C here, okay? So, your F1 is, what is your F1, students, you got?
B, C plus A, C, sir.
B, C plus A, C, sir.
B, C plus A, C. Students, do you understand what your second step after finishing your truth table? This is your second step. So in the first step, based on the functions what they have given, I designed a truth table. From the truth table, I have designed K-maps and I got my expression for the functions or outputs what they have given. Okay. So F1 equal to AC plus BC and F1 equal to AC plus BC and F2 equal to AB bar plus AC. Okay. These are the two expressions what I got. Okay. Now is very, very important part we have, students. That is design of PLA table, PLA programmable table or PLA table. That is what? we got to design. Students, here the important thing that you got to check is what the specification, what are the specifications that they have given in the question. They ask you to use three inputs, whether it is satisfied or not. Students, here have we used three inputs or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, satisfied. Satisfied. Then how many outputs you are going to design here?
Two outputs.
So that is also satisfied. Now look at the third term. What they have given in the third term, that is number
three
of
three product terms.
Look at here. These are the product terms we got here. These are the product terms we got after simplifying the K-maps. What are the product terms we got? AC, BC, AB bar, and AC. You can see here, students, AC is one product term. Okay, AC is one product term. Then AB bar is another product term. And
BC is another product term.
And you can see AC is repeated again. So we no need to use this AC again. Okay. So since the AC is redundant term or repeated term, this AC is no need to be considered again. So totally how many product terms we got after K-map simplification?
Three, sir.
Okay. So inputs is satisfied. We have used three inputs and we are designing two outputs. And finally, we got three product terms as they have mentioned. So exactly how they are asking, we are going to design in same way. So we are not about to worry about the things about input, output, and product terms. It is exactly correct in way, right in way. So you got AC, AB bar, and BC as our product terms, students. Okay. Now we go to design a PLA program table here. Okay. PLA program table. In that, you have products number. Okay. Nothing but product serial number, like 1, 2, 3. Product terms we have. And we need to mention what are the product terms you are having: AC, BC, and A bar B. We need to mention the product terms. And how they are, whether they are available in F1 and whether they are available in F2, that we have to mention here, students. Okay. So let me show you how you're going to mention or how you're going to design a programmable PLA table here, PLA design table. Look at here, students. Can you see the PLA table here? PLA table here?
Yes, sir.
See, yes, AC, sir. AC is one product term, BC is another product term, and AB bar is another product term. Three product terms we are mentioning in here, and we are naming them like 1, 2, 3, product term 1, product term 2, and product term 3. There are three product terms available. So we have satisfied with that. Now you go to check what are the inputs available. A, B, and C are the inputs available in the given design part. And there are two outputs available, F1 and F2. Look at here, students, how we need to fill the contents. Here I have A and C. So since in AC, I have A, I'm placing 1 here. Students, do you have B in the term of AC? Do you find any term like B in the term AC? No. No, that's why I'm placing a hyphen here. Then, do we find C in the term AC?
Yes, sir.
So I'm placing 1 in here. And also one important thing you got to check here is, do we have AC in F1 and F2? Do we have the term AC in F1 and F2?
Yes.
So I'm placing 1 under F1 and F2. So in both of them, I have AC. So I'm placing 1 and 1 in F1 and F2. Now let us go for the second product term we have, that is BC. Now check, the students, do we have A in the term BC? Do we have
No.
So I'm placing hyphen in here. Since we have B and C, I'm placing 1 and 1 under B and C. Students, now check whether BC is available in F1.
Yes, sir.
So I'm placing 1 under F1. Do we have BC in the F2, second output F2?
No, sir.
No. So I'm placing hyphen in here. Then go for the last product term, that is AB bar. Since we have A, I'm placing 1. Since we have B bar, not B, I'm placing 0 here. If you have B, I will write 1 here, students. Since I have a B bar, I'm placing 0. Since there is no C literal here, I'm placing hyphen in here. And also check in which output term, output function, we have AB bar. Do we have AB bar in F2. F1?
F2,
no.
Sir.
No, not there. So F1.
F2,
since we have in A B bar in F2, I'm placing one in here. Okay. Students, after designing this programmable logic or a program table, we need to mention T or C, true or complement under F1 and F2. Okay. We have to mention true or complement under F1 and F2. What is meant by true? What is meant by complement? In the question, they ask you to consider only three product terms. Do you got exactly the needed thing? Three
yes,
product
sir.
Terms. So yes, since we are considering only the three product terms, I'm writing T and T under F1 and F2. If that is not mentioned, or if that is not preferred, or if you are not getting that three product terms in the design part, we need to do some other thing. We need to do some other thing that I will explain you later, students, where you need to place C and C here. Okay. Where you need to place C in the design part. That is what very important that I'll explain now, where you need to place C. This is the programmable logic array, a program table. Students, do you have any doubts in design part of this one? How to take the product terms? How to mention the things under input and output? Any doubts in this PLA program table part?
No,
yeah. Then we have only the last thing, that is design part. Okay. This is also very, very simple, students. After getting the functions, it is very simple to design, but little bit different to your conventional circuit design part. First of all, we'll be doing the same. We'll be taking A bar, B, B bar, C and C bar. These are the input terms we have in the given function. Okay, we have A, B, C, we have A, B.